They're getting ready, by the way, for their opening statements, Randy. So I suspect the president, the two leaders, will be coming out fairly soon.
Yeah, I think we'll hear from them in less than a minute. So how do you see this ending, Wolf? And if we get interrupted here by the president, we'll cut back to you right after he speaks.
Yeah, we'll probably have the opening statements from the Chilean leader and then the president of the United States, and then they'll open it up to a few questions. I think it's still very much up in the air how this is all going to end. Obviously, the United States, the British, the French, the other coalition partners, and they're still hoping that there will actually be some real contribution from some of the Arab League countries. Qatar, for example, is indicating there they are right there. So I suppose we should listen in, Randy, don't you think?
All right, let's do that, Wolf, and we'll talk on the other side of these remarks.
Damas y caballeros, tengan todos ustedes muy buenas tardes. Bienvenidos a la conferencia de prensa conjunta de los presidentes de Chile y Estados Unidos.
And of the United
en primer lugar, hará uso la palabra su excelencia, el presidente de la República de Chile, señor Sebastián Piñera Echenique.
Muy buenas tardes.
Good afternoon,
en primer lugar,
everyone.
Quiero dar
Firstly,
la más cordial
I would like to
y calurosa bienvenida
and
a un amigo de Chile
a friend of
y a un amigo personal
and a person of
como presidente Obama.
Like President Obama.
Creo que su visita, presidente, es
visit,
muy importante
president,
y tiene un tremendo significado para Chile. Es primera vez en más de 20 años que un presidente de Estados Unidos visita nuestro país fuera de las cumbres multilaterales de líderes mundiales. Y además esta visita coincide con la conmemoración de los 50 años de la Alianza para el Progreso que fue anunciado por el presidente Kennedy a comienzo de la década de los 60. Hemos tenido con el presidente Obama una conversación franca
Obama, a very
y muy fructífera.
Open, frank and fruitful
y hemos podido
conversation.
Múltiples
we have been able to subscribe
de distinta naturaleza,
agreements of
pero que tienen algo común. Todos ellos
do have
contribuyen
in
a una mejor
they
vida
to a
y calidad de vida para nuestros pueblos, como la promoción
peoples,
del comercio
like
y acelerar y perfeccionar el tratado de libre comercio que tenemos con Estados Unidos,
perfect,
como la cooperación en el campo de la educación
States,
y la enseñanza del inglés
education,
para hacer de Chile un país bilingüe, como la colaboración en el desarrollo y uso eficiente de las energías y muy especialmente las energías limpias, renovables, en que Chile tiene un tremendo potencial, y también la colaboración en materia de investigación y tecnología y capacitación de nuestros ingenieros y técnicos en materia de energía nuclear. Pero en este campo quiero ser muy claro y categórico. Chile no va a construir
Chile
ni va
is not
a planificar
going to build,
construir
nor is
ninguna
planning
central
to build
de energía nuclear durante nuestro gobierno.
Nuclear power
a lo que apunta este acuerdo es a que podamos entender y conocer mejor
the idea of this agreement is that
las tecnologías
we understand
a poder capacitar más y mejor a nuestros ingenieros y técnicos
to be able to train
para que en el futuro
podamos
tomar decisiones más informadas y por tanto más inteligentes que protejan la salud
more
y la vida de nuestra población y también el medio ambiente y la naturaleza y además,
and
que nos permitan asegurar que el funcionamiento de nuestras dos centrales nucleares experimentales que existen hoy día sea plena y totalmente segura. También hemos firmado acuerdos para
also,
colaborar en materia de catástrofes naturales, en los mecanismos de alerta temprana y en los mecanismos de ayuda eficaz a la población civil, donde tenemos mucho que aprender de la experiencia de instituciones como FEMA en Estados Unidos.
To learn from
otro acuerdo
like
apunta
FEMA in the United
algo
States.
Que es el único verdadero recurso renovable
is something
en los tiempos modernos, la ciencia, la tecnología, la innovación y el emprendimiento,
science,
que tenemos que fortalecer en nuestro país para alcanzar
we need to strengthen our country so as to reach the development stage that we are seeking. And then finally, agreements to better protect our nature, our environment. I want to tell you, President Obama, that when you announce your visit to Chile, Brazil, and El Salvador, on the occasion of the State of the Union address, you said you were coming to forge new partnerships for the progress of the Americas. And you said that throughout all the world, you were committed to those countries that assume their responsibilities. Frankly, I think that Chile has assumed and will continue to assume its responsibility with our fate, with our region, with our country, and to the extent possible, with the rest of the world. And as we have been able to evidence in our conversations, not only today, but also in your country and in Asia, we have discovered that our two nations have a road of collaboration that can be built on rock and not on sand, because we coincide in that which is key, the values, the principles, the visions. That facilitates the road, and with that we can convincingly embrace this new alliance, this new partnership between the United States of America and the rest of the American countries. We are all Americans, an alliance that should be much deeper and forward-looking than the Alliance for Progress. And this partnership, this alliance, is one of our times, of our 21st century, of the society of information and technology. President Obama, Chile has set for itself an ambitious goal before the end of this decade to leave underdevelopment behind, to defeat poverty and to build a society of opportunities and assurance for all of its sons and daughters, and also to achieve a strong alliance among equals with the same rights, obligations of Latin America with the United States. And this is going to be very powerful, very useful in many fields: promotion of world peace, perfectioning of democracy, rule of law, and defense of human rights. But also in economic integration, where Chile aspires to accelerate, perfect, and deepen our free trade agreement with the United States. Also, we would like to raise our voice to ask for countries like Colombia and Panama also to have free trade agreements with your country and may join in this Trans-Pacific Partnership initiative. It's going to be a free trade area in both sides of the Pacific Ocean, and where we will find the largest free trade market in the world. Also, we are concerned about the delays and tensions of the Doha round. I know that the United States is going to make efforts for this to move forward. And then, on the other hand, I would like to raise to you a much closer collaboration in the field of science, technology, innovation, and undertaking. Because in modern times, free trade has to be not only of goods, but of ideas, not only of services, but of knowledge, not only of investments, but also of technology. And also, Mr. President, we are committed in the struggle against poverty and excessive inequalities in our country, in our continent. We want to keep on collaborating with the U.S. so as to contribute to other Latin American countries. Just like we can learn from them, they can learn from success stories in our country. And in combating the evils of modern society, fight against drug trafficking, terrorism, global warming, and the proliferation of massive destruction weapons and nuclear weapons. I was talking with President Obama in so far as avoiding this nuclear menace, but it's not only that a few countries in the world will have nuclear weapons and others not, but to have a world without weapons of mass destruction. This is the common goal we share with President Obama and with all the men and women of goodwill of all of the world. President Obama, I have read with great attention your words in El Cairo, Egypt, for the Arab world, where you proposed a new beginning in the relations between the United States and the Islam world. And also your words in Accra, Ghana, where you raised a new commitment, a new promise, a new commitment with the sub-Saharan African world. And today, that the winds of freedom, of democracy, of participation and protection of human rights are stronger than ever, even in those countries that had not existed for many years. This is a great opportunity to have a new alliance between the United States and the Latin American countries. That is why I would like to tell you that Latin America is more prepared than ever today, so as to leave poverty and underdevelopment behind that have been with us for 200 years of independent life and undertake the adventure of the future of democracy, of freedom, of development, of equality of opportunities, that we may have a continent, as we have dreamt it always, from Alaska to Tierra del Fuego, from the Pacific to the Atlantic Ocean, that will become a land of freedom, of opportunities, of progress, but also a land of fairness and camaraderie, as dreamt by the founding fathers of that great nation, like the United States, like the case of Jefferson, a great patriot like Lincoln, but also like San Martin and O'Higgins from our continent. And the question is a very straightforward one, a very simple one. It's our challenge, it's our mission, the mission of the generation of the bicentennial. Because if it's not now, then when? If we are not the ones, then who? Then President Obama, we are listening with great attention, with great interest, the message you will deliver in a few hours from the cultural center of La Moneda to the Latin America and to the whole world. Thank you very much.
Agradecemos las palabras del presidente
we
de la
thank
República
the words
Chile,
of the Sebastián President of the Republic of Chile, Mr. Sebastián Piñera Echenique. Now we will hear the President of the United States, His Excellency,